wanna be in the light, cause you are in the light. Wanna shine like the stars in the heavens. The Lord be my light, be my salvation. All I want is to be in the light. All I want is to be in the light. All I want is to be in the light. Good afternoon, church family. Welcome to this Wednesday edition of Staying Connected. I'm Jeremy Cole, the youth pastor here at St. Mary's United Methodist Church. As always, it is a joy and honor to greet you with God's word and prayer. Today we're continuing in our series, Red Letters. We're looking through the Gospel of John at different times that Jesus spoke. If you have a red letter Bible, you'll see that the words in red are Jesus' words in the Gospels, some parts of the epistles, and even in Revelation, you can see Jesus speaking. So today we are continuing on in chapter 12 of John, getting close to the end of chapter 12, and here we are today in verse 35 through 36. Then Jesus told them, "You are going to have the light just a little while longer. Walk while you have the light, before darkness overtakes you. Whoever walks in the dark does not know where they are going. Believe in the light while you have the light, so that you may become children of the light." When he had finished speaking, Jesus left and hid himself from them. Grass withers and the flower fades, but the word of our God endures forever. So, Jesus is speaking again about the light. We saw way back early in John's gospel where, if you happened to be with us that time, you saw that I lit a candle out of some complete darkness and showed how just a little bit of light can light up a small area. And so now Jesus is telling them again. He's reminding them that that they need to walk in the light, and that being in the darkness is hard to walk, because that's where dark things happen. My son asks me all the time, why don't we ever see bad guys around our house? And he's really into superhero movies, so he sees those bad guys, and then he sees the good guys fighting crime. And my answer for him usually is, well, bad guys don't usually come out in the dark. Bad guys don't usually come out in the daylight. They usually wait till it's dark. And, you know, we're lucky enough in our neighborhood that we haven't really ever had any sort of a bad guy issue. I know some neighborhoods do. All neighborhoods experience that to some extent at some point. No neighborhood is completely safe. But that's my easy answer for my son, is that, you know, bad guys usually come out in the dark. That's why we don't see them. And, you know, we're all usually asleep when it's dark. So, you know, Jesus is telling us that we need to walk in the light. We need to believe the light, him being the light of the world, and let that light guide everything we do, to also then reflect that light. Another experience I had about light and darkness that came to my mind today as I was preparing for this short devotion is the darkest dark I've ever experienced, I believe, was back during Hurricane Irma several years ago. I believe that the week following Hurricane Irma had to have been a new moon, because our neighborhood and most of the area, except for a few places, were out of electricity for at least 5 days. And that was the first time I had seen how dark it really can get in my neighborhood, because the streetlights weren't even on. You know, sometimes if our power goes out in our house, the streetlights are still on. But in this case, there was complete power outage through our neighborhood and several other areas here in Camden County. And like I said, it had to be a new moon, because we didn't even have the light of the moon to give us any light in the street. And that is the darkest that I've ever experienced almost anything. And it was dark at, you know, 9:30. And, you know, without any light to do anything else, we just kind of figured, let's go to sleep. So the darkness is uncertain. You feel unsafe in darkness. You don't know what's on the ground, because you don't have a light for your path. You don't know if you're going to bump into something else. You don't know if something's going to creep around the corner, whether it be an animal or a person, or sand gnats or mosquitoes. You know, you can't see anything coming, and it's scary. Sometimes you can't even see a few inches in front of your face. The darkness is terrifying. But we know that we have this light. We know that we have the light of Jesus. Hopefully you also have safety flashlights for when it does get dark, so you can light your path physically. But Jesus is that spiritual light that we're supposed to follow. Scripture says that the word, God's holy word, is a light to our feet and a lamp to our path. So we have to live like that's true. We have to believe it. We have to share that with others. And I believe that's what Jesus is telling everybody here, that he's around. I don't think it's a mistake that as soon as he says this, that he's talking about himself, as soon as he finishes talking about himself being the light and that they need to believe in the light, that he suddenly vanishes and he disappears from their sight. Probably goes off somewhere to be alone and pray, because what he just shared is very heavy. And he knows that his end is coming. He knows that his mortal end is coming. So I don't think it's a mistake that he's like, hey, y'all gotta believe in the light while it's here. And then in a blink, he was gone. To really kind of teach and then model, give him practice to live without the light, even just for a few moments there. And leave them with questions that they need to discover on their own through faith. So Jesus is the light. He's our light. He's shines out all the darkness in the world. Anything that is done in darkness will never be hidden from his sight. We've got to believe that. We've got to live like that's true. And we've got to be just reflections of his light of love in the world. So pray you'll take that with you and live like that's true today. Now let's pray. Lord, thank you for your love. Thank you for just the truth that you are the light of the world, that you shine out all the darkness, that we don't have to fear the darkness because we have you with us. Lord, just ask that your saving, loving light will reach to all the darkest places in our community, in the state, in our nation, in the world. God, we just pray that we become true lamps of you, of your light, that we'll be just light bringers to everyone around us. And people will know that we are Christians by our loving light. In your son's name we pray, amen.